Greetings. Good morning. We welcome you again to this live stream here, the Second Baptist Church, Frederictown. We welcome you to our live stream and conference call. And we thank God for another day and another day's journey that we can come together and fellowship one with another, even during this time of coronavirus and separation and isolation and all this stuff of separation and social distancing. But we know, we thank God that the body of Christ is still strong and God's word is still alive. And so we're grateful that you've tuned in with us this morning via live stream and even on conference call to hear a word from the Lord. And we just want to welcome you all of our members of here, Second Baptist Church, and then all of our friends who are tuning in locally and from around different areas. We just thank God for you. And we miss you so much. We cannot wait to come back together in the house of the Lord to worship and lift up his name. My wife and I were talking, and we just really miss the fellowship and seeing your faces. It seemed like we haven't seen you in so long. My wife and I, come on, babe, come on, say hello. We told her she wanted to come say hello this morning to you all, and we wanted her to come say the hi to everybody.
Good morning, Second Baptist. Happy Palm Sunday. I definitely miss all of you. I mean, just like my husband said, we were talking, especially after Bible study. Once we heard all the voices on the telephone, we also heard our new addition lady barking, and we're just so grateful that you were able to get online on Tuesday for Bible study and for prayer.
Wednesday,
yes, sorry. Please be safe. I want to thank all the essential personnel who are out, the doctors and the police officers, even the grocery store clerks. I just want to thank them for their support. Please be safe, wash your hands, and drink plenty, plenty of water. We love you all. We miss you all. And have a wonderful Palm Sunday.
Amen. Thank you so much. I know it's so good for y'all to see Hazelnut again, wasn't it? I know y'all miss my Hazelnut. Amen. We give God praise. Family, we just can't wait to really get back into fellowship. And she said, oh, we're so grateful for all those, although she mentioned those public service workers, first responders, those in the store who are still there for our convenience, even they have to work in the midst of this stuff. And so we're grateful for them and for their heart and their spirit still to be there to help meet our needs. Just a couple of quick announcements, family. We want to just say thank you to Deacon Key, and my wife mentioned Bible study on Wednesday night. We're just having a great time in Bible study. And thank you to all of you who have phoned in on the conference call on our line. And we are so grateful that you're participating. Numbers are up, and we thank God for that. And we are just having a wonderful time of Bible study every Wednesday night at 6 o'clock. So please, we encourage you to call in. And as my wife mentions, it was so good to hear everybody greeting each other, because I know we've been separated for what seems to be forever so far. And it was so good to hear everyone greeting each other and talking on the line. And we encourage you, if you're going to call in on Wednesday night at 6, please dial in before 6 o'clock, because the circuit gets busy and the line gets full. And the number, if you hear a busy signal, just call back and you can sign in. If you call in after 5, after 6, we ask, even though it prompts you to say your name, don't say your name, just come on in. Please put your phone on mute. But if you have a question or a comment, unmute yourself, say question or comment, and you'll be acknowledged to hear your question or receive an answer for your question or comment. And then just please put yourself back on mute so we can continue to learn of the Lord and be stronger in his word. And then we thank the Deacon Hayes and all the deacons ministry as they lead us in prayer. Listen, if we ever needed prayer, we need it now. And we thank God for our deacon ministry who are faithful and who lead us in prayer from 7 o'clock. To 8 o'clock on Wednesday night, immediately following Bible study on Wednesday night. You don't have to hang up and call back. You can just stay on the line with us as we seek God's face during this season that he might see us through. And we're grateful to God for all of that. Amen. We want to keep in prayer all those who are sick and shut in, all those who are bereaved or are going through loss. Want to lift up our own Deacon Walter and Deaconess Rose Brown, who was notified yesterday morning that they lost a niece. Sister Veronica Green, 50 years old, and her death, she died yesterday morning. It wasn't coronavirus related, but she has some other health issues, and we want to pray for them and their family. They're going through this season of bereavement in the midst of all the other things that we are facing on today. Amen. As my wife said, this week is Palm Sunday, and as you know, we will not be giving out palms on today because of the concern and issues of contact and transferring different things. So, but what we want you to do, however, we want you to do, we received a screenshot of a Facebook. I'm not on Facebook, but I received a screenshot on Facebook last week. And one of our own, Sister Kamika Hill, has sent out this post on Facebook. And she indicated that in memory and in recognition of Passover, that we should all get red ribbons and hang them over our doorposts. And so I'm encouraging you all today to go get a red ribbon and hang it over your doorpost. Every door that goes in and out of your home, hang it over the doorpost. I've already hung mine. I mean, he's hung ours over every door already. So hang your red ribbon over your doorpost. And yes, as the palms commemorate Jesus' triumphant entry to that hill called Calvary, and the red ribbon will represent the blood. That when he prayed the promise, when he sees the blood, he'll pass over us. So in lieu of Palm Sunday, we're asking you all to get a red ribbon. And if you know somebody who can't get out, a member of Second Baptist, get a red ribbon for them, drop it off, and put it over their doorpost so they might be covered and as a representation of the covering of the blood of Jesus. Amen. Next Sunday, family, as we know, we celebrate Resurrection Sunday. Amen. Not Easter, but Resurrection Sunday. For Christ got up on that day with all power in his hand, and we celebrate Resurrection Sunday. Watch this. And because we're not together, because we're not coming together in worship and fellowship, we didn't have our Holy Week services, obviously, because of limitations or numbers. But we will still have sunrise service. We want to meet you here next Sunday morning, 6 a.m. Listen, if he got up, you can get up. Amen. And thank God he got up. Because he got up, we too can get up. So we want to meet you here via live stream and conference call next Sunday morning at 6 a.m. as we celebrate Resurrection Sunday together here on next Sunday. Amen. So don't forget, then after sunrise service, we will have our morning service at 11 a.m. Here again on live stream and on conference call at 12 noon. So we invite you all, family, to come out next week. Listen, and even though we're home, and even though it's 6 a.m. early in the morning, after all he's done for you, you can get up next Sunday morning at 6 a.m. and give God praise for the resurrection power. Amen. Also, next week, family, as we are, and again, in this time of separation, we will still honor our commitment and have communion one with another. We will take the Lord's Supper, and what we'll do it via live stream and via conference call. And so what we're asking you to do between now and next week is, most of you probably have these items already, please have some crackers or some bread, either one, at home on next Sunday, and also some juice. Now, we don't want you to get no wine. Don't get no Christian Brothers. Come on here, help me, somebody. Don't get your favorite beverage. No, get some juice. Amen. Whatever we would use in the sanctuary. And we want you to have that prepared, because next week, after Sunday morning service, our regular 11 a.m. Worship service, we will break bread together and take communion. And we want you to do it right there in your own home. Amen. You and your family. Amen. Taking communion. We'll lead you through it via live stream and or conference call as we can take communion in the Lord's Supper one with another, remembering the great sacrifice that he did for us. Amen. And recommit ourselves to him again, that we might live our lives pleasing and acceptable to him. So please have your crackers and bread and juice ready on next Sunday after our morning 11 o'clock morning worship service, that we might partake in communion one with another. Amen. I want to say congratulations to one of our young people. We're so proud of our young people here at Second Baptist Church. And even during this time that they're not in school, but still having to do homework from home and having to make a sacrifice and commitment to get up early and get on that computer and do what they need to do. We want to say congratulations to our own brother, Jonathan Miller. Praise God, who has made the honor roll at Kingway High School for the first semester. We're proud of you, Jonathan. Keep up the good work, brother. And we know I heard from a little bird told me that you better keep it up with your mom. I ain't going to say no more. I ain't going to tell you told me. But we say congratulations to Jonathan and all our young people who are doing great work. And young people, again, if you're doing great work, let me know so we can give you a shout out and let the world know how great our young people here all right, Second Baptist Church, Pedricktown. Amen. I want to say happy birthday again to all those who are celebrating a birthday, to all those who might be celebrating a wedding anniversary. We say happy anniversary, happy birthday to you all. We wish you many, many more. And even in the midst of this season, please celebrate. Celebrate another year of life. And celebrate another year of marriage to your husband or to your wife. Amen. One more year that God has been faithful and allowed you to roll on. So we give God the praise. Amen. We want to ask that all of you, those that have email, please keep a check on your email. I'm sending updates out to keep us informed about what's going on in the church. Keep us informed about different activities and things that we are doing. And then to keep you informed about where we are in relation to this coronavirus and what we're doing as a church to get through this season. So I'm sending out emails once or twice a week. So please keep check your emails. They're coming from Sister Cleo, who's sending them out from us, our secretary. And so please keep checking your emails so that you can be in tune and we can all be on one accord. Amen. As we continue to do the work of the Lord in his kingdom. Amen. Amen, family. Let's get into the word of God. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you once again for your goodness. We thank you for your grace. We thank you, God, for this time together that we can come together, God, via live stream, even over a conference call, God, and lift up your name. For you said, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me. So now, God, we come to this time of preaching. We ask that you would speak to me and speak through me. Then, God, prepare the ears of your people, even over live stream, even over the conference call, God, that they might hear a word from you. Encourage their hearts, Lord God. Touch their spirit. Remind them, Father God, that you still sit on the throne. We love you today. We give your name the glory and the praise. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. It's in Jesus' name we pray and ask it all. And everyone that loved the Lord, say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. To him be all the praise. We give honor to God, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, in the power and presence of the Holy Spirit, even in this place. And once again, family, we thank God for his presence here. Amen. And we praise God for, again, for Brother Gibson, who's recording us. Amen. And of course, to my Hazelnut, who you heard from. And we just thank God. He said, where two or three are gathered in my name, he shall be in the midst. We thank God that he's here with us. So today, family, we want to not hold you long, but we want to look at this text today. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. One verse of scripture today. I want to look at this and just gather a few things from the text and that the Lord has given us to share with you and be out your way. Is that all right? Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2. The Bible reads, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. Amen. The word of the Lord is already blessed. Family, if you allow me just for a few moments on this morning, we want to talk to you from the thought of an idea that each of us during this season of coronavirus, each of us during this time of isolation and separation, each of us, that we stay focused. Come on, tell somebody, stay focused.
Stay focused.
My brothers and my sisters, we thank God for his awesome wonder. We thank him for his unmerited favor and his abounding mercy for allowing us to see another day, for allowing us to enter a new month in this new year, this first Sunday in April, for allowing us to come together again in fellowship, one with another via live stream or a conference call, and lift up his name, for allowing each of us to wake up this morning and experience brand new mercies of a brand new day. Well, somebody ought to shout thank you on this morning. For Jeremiah wrote in his Lamentations 3:22, it is the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed because his compassions fail not. But he didn't stop there. He didn't leave it there, family. No, he went on to say in verse 20:23, and he gave a shout of praise unto our God. He said about the mercies that he gives us. He said, they are new every morning. Anybody know grateful for new mercies every morning? And he said, great is thy faithfulness. I'm quite sure somebody can testify that our God's faithfulness is great. Are you happy about it on today? Oh, bless his name. So family, you need to remember. You need to remember that even during this time of global chaos and pandemic, that our God is faithful and our God is great. Can I hear witness in this place? Yeah, our God is faithful and our God is great. Yet, I know, family, I know it might be hard right now having to stay in the house, can't go nowhere, got to put on a mask like you're from outer space and all these limitations being put on you. I know it may be rough and we are going through a trial. I know we are experiencing an event that we were unprepared to handle and that we're not used to. Oh, but be encouraged on today, my brothers and my sisters, for there's good news. Come on, tell somebody there's good news. There's good news. Come on, help me preach this thing. There's good news. The good news is, family, is that God is still in control. Oh, you missed a chance to shout right there. Let me say it again. The good news is that God is still in control. However, I understand it may not seem like it. You might be questioning and doubting it. Oh, but my assignment on this morning is to remind you that he is. Come on, somebody say he is. He is still in control. And because he's still in control, we can, with confidence and with great assurance, know that he knows. He knows exactly what we need. I wish I had some help on this morning. That is why, family, that is why, even in the midst of these frightening and terrifying days, we, family, the saints of God, can boldly proclaim the words of that 121st division of Psalm. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills. Come on, talk to me today. From which cometh my help. My help. Anybody grateful for your help? Your help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. Now watch this. For the Bible declares, he will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. Here it is. You should shout on this. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade and thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil, from coronavirus. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. And it's because, family, it's because of this promise that we want to just encourage your heart on today and to strengthen you to stay focused. Come on, tell somebody in your house, stay focused. Yeah, stay focused, stay focused. The question is, well, in the midst of all this craziness, in the midst of all this that is going on, not only in our nation, but in the world, what are we to stay focused on? Thank you. I'm glad you asked. Watch this. Here it is. The first thing, you are not to stay focused on the television and news reports. Yes. Come on, I wish you had somebody here on the day. Did you hear me? No. For if you stay focused, family, if you stay focused on the TV, and you will inadvertently allow doubt, hopelessness, and fear to enter into your spirit. Did you hear me? You cannot focus on the TV and the news reports. Now, for our God has not given us a spirit of fear. Come on, help me preach this thing. But if we are not careful, if we don't watch ourselves, we don't monitor what we allow to come in, if we don't guard our minds, if we don't guard our hearts, if we don't guard our spirits, family, fear will creep in. Fear will take over because our focus, watch this, is on the report of CNN, NBC, CBS, Fox, and all those other outlets, watch this, who all have agendas. Did you hear me? Probably have some time. And trust me, all of their agendas are not of God, if I had some help here today. Well, again, question may be asked, what are we to stay focused on? Not to stay focused on TV, and you are not to stay focused. Watch, I got to say it. I don't want to say it, Brother Robert, but you are not to stay focused on the White House. I wish I had some help here. No, because Lord knows they are in complete and utter disarray and confusion. Can I get a witness? You can't, family, put your confidence in folk who say one thing today. Matter of fact, they say one thing this hour and something completely different the next hour. And then try to convince you they said the same thing all along. Y'all don't want to help me on this morning. Now you can't put your confidence in the White House. No, family. You can't stay focused, here it is, on anything or anybody in this world. Yeah. Did you hear me? Yeah. But in this season, during this time of pandemic, my brothers and my sisters, you have to stay focused on the cross. Yeah. You have to stay focused on Jesus. Come on here. Let me help you stand. Get out your way. Even though, family, the world, even though our communities, even though our lives have been turned upside down because of this coronavirus, I'm here to tell you that the one thing that has not changed, the one thing that has not been altered, the one thing that has not been impacted in this season is the power of the cross. Did you hear me? The one thing that has not changed is the sacrifice that was made upon that cross. Come on and talk to me on this morning. Because our Savior, our Redeemer, our Deliverer, Jesus. Somebody shout, Jesus. Jesus has not changed. Are you praying with me on this morning? Yeah, family. Jesus is, this week, Jesus is looking toward that hill called Calvary. Jesus is looking toward what the songwriter called that old rugged cross. Come on here, somebody. Jesus is looking to make that ultimate sacrifice this week. Jesus is focused on the cross. Yeah. Let us not forget, family, that we too, you and I, my brothers and sisters, even in the midst of our trials, you and I, my brothers and sisters, even in the thick of our tribulations, you and I, my brothers and sisters, even in the center of coronavirus, must stay focused on the cross and focused on Jesus. Are you with me on this morning? We must stay focused, family, because during these trying times, yeah, it is so easy for all of us to be distracted. Yeah. Did you hear me? Yeah. It's easy for us to get distracted by the things that are going on in this old world. It's easy for us to get distracted by the things that we're hearing and seeing. It's easy for us to get distracted. And you must understand, you must understand, family, that distraction is a trick of the enemy. Yeah. I wish I had some help. While all of us are limited now, all of us now are limited in our normal, highly active lives. We now more than ever find ourselves with an enormous amount of time to either stay focused or be distracted. I know I write about it. You don't have to talk to me. We do. We do. And watch this. Because of that, we can stay focused during this time of self-confinement and shelter-in-place mandates, and we can seek God's face. We can listen for God's voice. We can study God's word. And we can strengthen our walk with him, that even during coronavirus, we will be a witness to others that God is still on the throne. Can I get a witness here? Have you taken a moment and thought about or even considered that maybe God is trying to get your attention, Christian? Yeah. Maybe God is trying to get your attention, church. Yeah. Maybe God is making you slow down. Mm. Listen to his voice. Mm. If I only have some time, I gotta let you go. We can choose to stay focused, or we can choose, watch this, we can choose to be distracted, yeah, by the report of the world. We can choose to be distracted by the news media. We can choose to be distracted by entertainers or those who have celebrity and have become self-appointed spokespersons for the conditions of the world. Watch this. And they try to get you, my brothers and my sisters, they try to get you, church, they try to get you, Christian, to align yourself and come into agreement with unacceptable behaviors that God in his word have said is wrong, but have become normal practice and acceptable lifestyles by those who want you to live by, watch this, their own truth and not God's truth, if I only have some time. Well, our text today, family, arises to us from this 12th chapter and second verse of Hebrews. And Hebrews, family, was written to a people who had left Judaism to follow Christ. But because of the pressures and cruelty of the day against those who would confess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, they would cause some folks to waver in their faith. And watch this, turn their backs on the blessings of the promises of God. Yeah, unfortunately, then, just like now, there were some folks, some people who were more influenced by the opinions of other folk than the promises of God. Come on, talk to me here on today. Let me say it again. There were some people then, just like now, who come to church Sunday after Sunday, who are more influenced by the opinions of others than the promises of God. Yet the text, family, the text, Hebrews, remind us, and it reminds them that Christ is greater than their former man-made rules and rituals and religious regulations. Come on here. Yes, that Jesus is greater than Moses. Jesus is greater than the angels. Jesus is greater than the Aaronic priesthood, because their sacrifices were only temporary, but his sacrifice is eternal. Well, somebody ought to be shouting thank you right there. I wish I had some help on this morning. Yes, and in spite of all that they face, in spite of every opposition, family, in spite of every enemy, every threat, every sickness, every disease, every pestilence, that's virus if you didn't know, the people of God then, as they are today, were reminded in this book of Hebrews, chapter 4, verses 14-15, seeing then that we have a great high priest that has passed into heaven, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our profession. For we have not a high priest which cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmity, but was in all points tempted like as we are. What? Here it is. Yet without sin. Yes, my brothers and my sisters, look at somebody next to you and remind them. He knows. Yeah, come on, tell me. He knows. He knows exactly what you are going through. He knows. Someone tell somebody else. He knows. He knows exactly what you are facing. He knows. He knows the enemy that we are fighting against. He knows. That is why, family, that we must stay focused and not be distracted, even in this season. I'm almost out your way. Here it is. Here it is. Here it is. The text, family, the text gives us a demonstration of what we all need during this trying season of concern and uneasiness. And that, my brothers and sisters, I submit to you, that is endurance. Yeah. Somebody say endurance. But Jesus here in our text, he exhibits to us what endurance looks like. Even in the midst of a storm. Did you hear me? Oh, forgive me. I was wrong. Forgive me. Jesus, he is in the up against the storm. Now, but Jesus, he demonstrates endurance against something greater than the storm. Here it is. He's up against life and death. Yet he stayed focused on his assignment. He stayed focused on the cross. Come on, somebody shout, stay focused.
Stay focused.
Yeah, yeah. For Jesus is facing the certainty of death approaching. Watch this. Not because he deserved it. Not because he had done anything wrong to warrant it. Not because he had committed a crime, a sin, or other violation. No, but only because he desired, my brothers and sisters, that you and I might live. Oh, you missed a chance to shout right there. I feel his presence in this place. Did you hear what I said? Jesus did not deserve to die. Christ was innocent of every charge leveled against him. Jesus Christ, holy, pure, and righteous, looked at the certainty of death, only so that you and I, my brothers and sisters, might have a right to the tree of life. I feel like a shout coming on in this place. Hallelujah! 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 Bless his holy name. Yes, notice if you will, the text, I'm almost out your way. The text says that he is the author, the originator, the creator, the composer of our faith. Let me help you understand. Jesus here in our text, family, he shows us a perfect example of faith and staying focused that each of us should strive to emulate daily in our walk. Here it is, for the Bible declares in Romans 12 and 3, that God has dealt to every man a measure of faith. And the question becomes, even to us during this pandemic, the question becomes to each and every one of us viewing live stream and hearing us on conference call, the question becomes, how's your faith? Come on, ask somebody sitting next to you, how's your faith? Come on, how's your faith? That's the question for each of us today. Is your faith wrapped up only in those things that you are able to see? Because Hebrews 11 and 1 tells us, now faith is the substance of things hoped for. Come on, watch that, some Bible readers here. The evidence, watch this, of things not seen. Or is your faith only predicated on things that you have control over? Come on here. Things that you can regulate. But you ain't got no control over this. It's coronavirus, ain't no control, you can't do nothing about it. Things that you can manage. But just remember, my brothers and sisters, just remember a few verses down in Hebrews 11, verse 6 says, but without faith, come on, help me in this place, it is impossible to please him. For he that comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently, oh, here I go again, diligently seek him. Come on, one more time. Ask somebody, how's your faith? How's your faith? Bless his name. The text says that not only is Jesus the author of our faith, but it says that he is also the finisher of our faith. He's the closer. He's the culmination of our faith. In other words, my brothers and my sisters, when we have relationships, somebody say relationship. Come and preach this thing. When we have relationship with Jesus, he is the fulfillment of our faith. And watch this. He gives us the ability, here it is, to walk through even the valley of the shadow of death and yet fear no evil. I wish I had some help in this place. Yes, when we have an intimate relationship, when we have an intimate fellowship with the Lord, he completes us. Did you hear me? He completes us, and there is nothing, somebody shout nothing. There is nothing that is lacking in us. Oh, I understand, family. I understand now. I understand why Paul could say, stay focused on living a life that was committed to the Lord and declare in Philippians 4:13, you know the scripture, I can do all things. I wish I had some help here. Through Christ, that strengthens me. Say yes. Yes. Oh, bless his name. I'm almost out your way. My brothers and my sisters, Jesus stayed focused on the cross, and the text says that he kept his focus. Here it is. For the joy that was set before him. If I only had some time. Wait a minute, preacher, pastor. Are you trying to tell me that Jesus had joy en route to death? It's right there in your text. Look at your text. He says, the joy that was set before him, watch this, which allowed him to fulfill his purpose in God. Oh, somebody needs to grab hold of that one today. And know, family, know that no matter what it looks like, in spite of whatever it is that you're going through, regardless of coronavirus and sickness and even death all around you, somebody needs to know that there's a purpose. Somebody shout purpose. There is a purpose for your life. That's a praise all by itself. There's a purpose. Yes, family, you must stay focused and not be sidetracked, watch this, by these earthly issues that may make you default, here it is, on your heavenly assignment. Come on, tell somebody there's a purpose for your life. Stay focused. Stay focused. Stay focused because God has a plan for your life. That's why Paul writes to his protege in 2 Timothy 1:9, he who have saved us and called us with a holy calling. Watch this. Not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace. Here it is, which was given in Jesus Christ before the world began. Come on, tell somebody, stay focused. Bless his holy name. I'm almost at your way, family. I got to let you go. But Jesus, as Jesus stayed focused on that hill called Calvary, just as Jesus stayed focused on the cross, where he would hang, bleed, and die for you and for me. We too, family, must stay focused on the cross and on the Lord and on his word, even in this season of what the Bible called pestilence. Well, you do know that what coronavirus is, don't you? Pestilence, a fatal epidemic disease. And watch this, because of that, even in the face of coronavirus, even in the face of pestilence, watch this, because of the promises of God, I've got joy. Yeah. Anybody got joy on today? Come on, don't fool me now. I've got joy. Why do I have joy? Because of Psalm 91. He that dwelleth in the secret place. Anybody know about the secret place? Of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. Watch this. My God, in him will I trust. And I like verse 3. Surely, come on, somebody say surely. Surely, surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noise of pestilence. There it is. You ought to be shouting the victory right now in your house. I've got joy. Joy on the inside. Because just a little further down, Psalm 91, family, here it is, and I'm gone. It says, because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation. Here it is, and I'm shouting, I'm gone. There shall no evil. Did you hear me? No evil. I wish I had some help. No evil befall thee. This is just shouting, we're done. Neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling place. I told you, put that red ribbon on your door. And when he sees the blood, hallelujah, when he sees the blood, he shall pass over. I've got joy. And this joy that I have, The world didn't give it. And the world, I wish I had some help here. The world can't take it away. More importantly, I'm going to tell you, I got joy. I've got joy because I've got Jesus. But more importantly, I've got joy because Jesus got me. Can I get a witness in this place? Hallelujah. If you don't know Jesus, family, today, if you don't have joy, even in the midst of this coronavirus, you're not staying focused because of all these distractions have your attention that are taking place in this world. We want to take time out, take a moment right now just to give you an opportunity to get this joy that we're talking about, this unspeakable joy, this joy that surpasses all understanding, that even in the midst of trial, even in the midst of coronavirus, even in the midst of chaos in your life, you can still celebrate victory because you have Jesus. And more importantly, Jesus has you. Do you have that joy on the inside? Do you know that you're safe in the arms of Jesus even during this season of coronavirus? Well, family, if you don't, we're giving you an opportunity during today to make Jesus your choice. And so if there be one watching us via live stream or listening to us via conference call and you have not confessed Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, listen, we open up the doors of the church to you today. That means we're giving you an opportunity to come into right relationship with Him. Because listen, you can't stay here forever. And one day, you'll have to leave this place. And there's only two places you can go. Heaven, with God eternally, or hell, eternally, where there's forever there's torment, trial, and pain. And I know folks don't want to hear about hell, and don't believe hell exists. But yeah, there is a hell, and folks talk about some. No, I'm living in hell now. No, you're not, because you can laugh. You can smile, you can have good days, but in hell, there's no good days. It's torment and pain constantly, eternally. And so we're taking a moment, family, if you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, to give you an opportunity to come into right relationships. Somebody say relationships with Him. It's not about church membership, but it's about relationship. We would love to have you come be a part of Second Baptist Fredericktown, but we're not concerned about where you join. We're concerned about you having relationship with Jesus. So if there's one today, you've never confessed Him as Lord and Savior. We're going to ask everybody to just close your head and just pray with me. Heavenly Father, I thank you for your goodness. I thank you for your grace and mercy in my life. God, I acknowledge that I'm a sinner. And God, I acknowledge that I need a Savior. God, I believe God sent you His one and only begotten Son. And I believe the word that whoever shall believe in Him should have life and life everlasting. So God, I confess you this day as my Lord and my Savior. Come into my heart, Lord God. Create me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within. God, use me for your glory that I might tell others about your grace and your mercy. God, do a new thing in my life. And then, God, I'll surrender my life to you. God, I thank you for salvation on this day. I surrender all. You are my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer with me, my brothers and my sisters, you're saved today, and we encourage you, after this season of separation, after this season of isolation, that you find a church, Bible preaching, Bible teaching church, where the only star of the show is Jesus Christ, not the preacher, not the pastor, man or woman, no, they're not to be uplifted, only Jesus is to be uplifted. You find yourself a church, you come to Second Baptist Fredericktown, we would love to have you, Bible preaching, Bible teaching church, where the only star is Jesus Christ. So today, family, we thank you all for tuning in today and calling in on a conference call. And we would love to meet you face-to-face after this season is over. And if the Lord allows us to get back together in His house to give His name the glory. But in the meantime, if you desire to support this ministry, Second Baptist Fredericktown, we would love for you to send your contributions to Second Baptist Church, P.O. Box 74, Fredericktown, New Jersey, 08067. We thank you in advance for your kindness, and may God richly bless you and your family. And remember, stay focused. Come on, tell somebody, stay focused. We love you on today. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time together. We thank you for your spirit. God, we thank you for these, your people, over live stream and even on the conference call. Now, God, keep us focused, Lord God, on the cross. For it's at the cross, where I first saw the light. And the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there, by faith, I received my sight. And now, I am happy. God, we thank you. Most of all, we thank you for your son, Jesus. Keep us, Lord, until we meet again. May the love of God, sweet communion, and soul, and spirit rest with and abide both now and forevermore. In every heart that loves Jesus, said amen, amen, and amen. God bless you on this day.